Hello everyone, welcome to Dutch Aviation Blog. My name is Niels and I'm very excited. reason for that is this weekend KLM is retiring their Fokker 70s, which is very sad, of course. As a Dutchman, I really like Fokker. It's a part of our heritage as well. And it's gone after this weekend, at least from Dutch soil. They won't scrap it, luckily, they will use it. Other airlines bought the Fokkers, probably in Australia, no, most definitely in Australia. I don't know exact airlines, but I do know Insel Air from Aruba, I believe, has bought some. It was just for KLM. Since Fokker has gone bankrupt, their maintenance costs increased, of course, since there were less and less parts available. So that's why they decided to retire it this year and replace it with all Embraers. But this, yeah, that's pretty sad, of course. I really like Fokker. I love Fokker, actually, my favorite aircraft. Together with the 747-400, of course, or just 747 in general. But, you know, there's a time to say goodbye to old aircraft and replace them with new ones. But I really like this, so I'm going to give you a quick tour of the Fokker 100, which is located at the Panorama Terrace, Schiphol. So, right here is its steel section with the very famous Rolls-Royce T620, there they are. Of course, the true engines within. These are just the cowlings. The engines are replaced, they're gone, they're probably sold or scrapped. I do not know for certain. And what's also pretty fun about the Fokker, so the N100, is that the landing lights extend down from the wing, just like an MD-80. And that also gives you a little more extra sink rate. So it slows also the aircraft a bit more down. What's also particularly great about this aircraft is that it has the famous clam brakes. I do not know if you know what they are. Probably you do if you really love aviation. Or if you just like aviation, you probably know what they are. The behind of that aircraft, as you see, has some bulky things. And it's not... the end of the aircraft is not entirely attached. There are some crevices, and that crevice, it's actually the clam brake, which is actually a very powerful brake for if you want to land on a short runway, this is the way to go. Of course, the Fokker also has some speed brakes on the wings, thrust reversers, as you can see right there. Beautiful detail. This is the Pop Hotel Oscar Foxtrot Echo, yes. So it has been donated by KLM to Schiphol, which is very nice. And we're going to take a look inside. I'm inside the Fokker 100. His wing, there's a 747 taking off. I really have to go to security now, because otherwise I will miss my Fokker flight and that will be a disaster, actually. It would be horrible. But this is the cockpit, but I'll show you the real thing. This is the real thing, but on an actual aircraft that still flies in a few hours, so don't worry. Let's see. Thank you. To go to the airport. I'm going to have breakfast first, see a little bit of the city. Don't have much time though, less than an hour, but then again, that's fine. I'll be flying the Fokker today. So once again, I flew it yesterday evening as well. I was planning to make a trip report yesterday evening, but I'm going to make one tonight to the flight for Durham because I just came outside. Going to check out a little bit of the city and then straight to the train, having a bit of breakfast or something like that. And can recommend that hotel, Hotel de Park. Oh, that one, Mulhouse.
So I'm taking the train out to the airport. Up to the airport. Wobbly.
Yeah. jump seat.
Welcome home on a safe and pleasant onward journey. Thank you, enjoy the rest of your day and goodbye. Dames en heren, welkom in Amsterdam. Wil je als vlieg blijven zitten? Tot op de richting